Hello and welcome, my name is al.zee and today we are starting the complete playthrough of this great and truly legendary game called Baldur's Gate 3. In this playthrough I'm going to try to explore all storylines, complete all possible quests and do so with minimal save load spamming. This is gonna be cozy and unhurried, yet thrilling and fully immersive adventure. So buckle up, cause we're about to begin. Good question. What kind of character would I like to play with? So after some consideration I decided to choose Ranger class. As I understand, with this class I'm going to be able to be a somewhat good melee fighter, as well as having a number of spells to cast. And that's kind of what I want, to play with a character that has abilities of both worlds. And if we're speaking about other preferences, I just went with those that give me better proficiencies, so I have better chances at rolling dice in different contexts. That was a tough choice there. I might regret it in the future. But I decided to go with animal handling because I know for a fact that we will be dealing with quite a bit of animals in our adventure.
Hells. Something just woke up down here.
It's opened.
There's magic keeping this chair.
Let's hope the local.
Hells. Something just.
It's opened.
There's magic keeping this chest sealed.
What was that?
Finally, the character creation and all the intros are over, and we can begin playing the game.
What's inside? Dead. Good.
We find ourselves on this mysterious alien ship called the Nautiloid. This is the only chance we get to explore this place, so I will take my time to try and find all the loot I can.
Project into your mind. A Nautiloid hurtling through the plains, resplendent with psionic energy.
Where the hells are we?
Came from the parasite now writhing behind your eye.
And here we are, the ruler of it all, the rolling dice, which will decide our fate all over the place. Success on our first roll. A sign of good luck? I doubt it.
The casing is fragile. The slightest touch could cause it to crumble.
Just so you know, if I chose to touch it, it would have exploded and damaged me for some HP.
Images of goblins, their habits and histories flash into your mind. A 1,000 years of humanoid history, elves, dwarves, humans and more flash behind your eyes.
Doesn't do anything. What's up for discussion?
Yes, you've come to save us from this place. From this place you'll free us.
The exposed brain quivers in expectation.
Please. Before they return! They return. The enemy! So many enemies!
A newborn.
Born new from this husk.
You know no creature like this. One that is more brain than person.
Do
Remove us.
From this body.
From this case. Free us. Please.
You notice edema. A swelling of the brain causing pressure where it strains against the shell of the skull. The brain lifts from the skull, but you notice an opportunity. You could cripple the strange creature, making it more subservient, should it prove a threat.
So close. If I'd been successful on that last roll, this brain would have joined me and helped me in battle. We're about to meet our first companion.
Abomination. This is your end.
Your head throbs and your skin tingles. Visions rush past. A dragon's wing, a silver sword, and a flash of your face seen through the strange woman's eyes.
Ugh. My head. What is this? Skvar. You are no thrall. Vlakith blesses me this day. Together, we might survive. We carry mind flayer parasites. Unless we escape, unless we are cleansed, our bodies and minds will be tainted and twisted. Within days, we will be Geth, mind flayers. We can do nothing until we escape. That must be our priority. First, we exterminate the imps. Then we find the helm and take control of the ship. We will address the matter of a cure for this infection once we reach the material plane.
First combat, but this one's gonna be easy.
Easy. much for peace.
You proved surprisingly adequate in battle. Now, to the helm.
Take another dragon attack. We need to get out before it's too late.
Isn't dead, but he's totally unresponsive. Psionic energy radiates from the prisoners, but they do not react.
Let my name be known.
Sometimes the only way out is through.
Akido!
Swift and lethal.
No one back home will ever believe this. Deep and move.
You! Get me out of this, Captain!
We have no time for stragglers.
The construction is too alien. Nothing looks familiar.
This ship is crashing. Do you intend to die for a stranger?
Try that contraption next to the pod. They did something to it when they sealed me in. Hurry! Please!
And that's our second companion, yet to be freed from her captivity.
The console appears dormant. The mechanisms are completely unrecognizable at first, but then you spy an empty socket. Nothing. The console remains dormant.
Whatever fits in that socket must power this thing.
You are not us!
up.
Woman is trapped inside the pod. She doesn't notice you.
This might unlock those controls next to the pod. Brain in a jar.
As you place your hand on the pod, you hear something. A presence connected to the pod, commanding the person inside to change. At you, weak and dazed.
Maggots will be done.
The newborn mind fled.
No time to rest. On my way.
Appear in your mind, a brain, a Githyanki warrior, and centuries of darkness.
Damn it!
The console appears dormant. The console hums to life, but what is its purpose? Will it free the captive, or transform her like that other unfortunate? The pulsing glow and organic lines of the device make it seem more like a beating heart than a machine. This device is different from the one that caused the other captive to transform. Perhaps it will open the nearby pod. Suddenly, you feel a hideous squirming in your head. A parasite. Then discomfort fades, and another sensation washes over you. Connection. Authority. Mechanical brain of the console process your command and yield to it. A shiver runs across your mind. You feel sated.
Thing was going to be my coffin. Thank you.
Your mind lurches into her thoughts. Her gratitude is mixed with wariness, because you have a gith with you.
You keep dangerous company. Fair point.
Looks like there's plenty of fighting ahead. Let me come with you. We can get off this ship and watch each other's backs along the way. I did. It must be because of those parasites they put in us. But that'll have to wait. Are we going to help each other or not? Shadowheart. One moment. It's nothing. Trust me.
Enough of this chatter. We need to get to the helm. Now.
She's right. Lead on.
There is work to do.
I prepare this spell because it is going to help us in the next fight.
Can't give up now. Here we go. Wonder if the gods are watching me. Mind flayer horticulture.
We are nearing the helm. Once inside, do as I say.
Who put you in charge? I'll trust my own judgment.
Kanyank. We will deal with the Geich after we escape.
This thing's falling fast. Got to right it.
So this is our last fight before landing. Not very hard, but what makes it a bit more difficult is my wish to collect as much loot as possible.
Feet.
Victory awaits. Worth examining.
Another fight. Let's go.
Swift and lethal. What lies within?
Can't concentrate.
I wonder if this is worth the cost.
Before they strike!
Survival is all that matters.
Might as well.
Time to push my luck again.
Got to focus.
Nothing will stand in my way. Best be on my way.
Time to strike. I will take my pick. Check for anything useful.
Blood comes easy these days.
Taking position.
From here. Very well.
I am fury. I am death.
Come on, can't stay idle.
Alien transponder. You made it in time.
Of course, it would have been great if I had been able to kill all the enemies in that fight, but that would have been quite hard and require some save loading, which I decided to minimize in my playthrough. And though I didn't kill Commander Jalk, I did manage to get his sword, which is quite nice.
As you wake, the tadpole squirms in your skull. Other than the infection, you're more or less intact. A miracle, given everything you've been through, but it'll all be for nothing if you don't find help soon. The tadpole is a death sentence, and the clock is ticking. You need a cure.
Finally, we're on land, and the first order of business is to gather our party.
Recognize this place, but anything's an improvement on where we just came from. First things first, we need supplies, shelter, and most of all a healer. We might have escaped, but we still have these little monsters in our heads. We need each other. And we both know what's at stake. Can't think of better company. One thing, just before we go. I wanted to thank you again for freeing me. It would have been all too easy for you to run right past my pod, but you didn't. I'll remember that. Lead the way.
More of those wretched things.
Our first level up and the first spells that I can choose for my character. I decided to take some healing spells and improve my archery damage so I can more effectively attack from distance.
Huh.
stay back. One strike could be lethal.
Can't afford any mistakes.
Another fight. Let's go.
Survival isn't such a distant prospect.
Anything of use? That'll fit in my pack. Something good here, I hope. Fresh water. There must be a settlement nearby. exist. I've got one of those brain things cornered. There, in the grass. You can kill it, can't you? Like you killed the others? There. Can you see it? You want to keep that darling neck of yours. And you, keep your distance. No need for this to get messy.
I need him alive. Stow that blade, or I'll show you just how messy things can get.
Promises, promises. But I have other business, I'm afraid. Now, I saw you on the ship, didn't I? Nod. Splendid. And now you're going to tell me exactly what you and those tentacled freaks did to me. Don't lie to me.
Your mind twists. You're looking out of unfamiliar eyes, prowling dark, busy streets. You try to hold the memory, but it fades to the worm. The light, the fear.
What was that? What's going on? I saw into your mind. They took you. Just the same as me. And to think, I was ready to decorate the ground with your innards. Apologies. Indeed we are. Please, allow me to introduce myself. My name's Astarion. I was in Baldur's Gate when those beasts snatched me. Is that so? We clearly move in different circles. So, do you know anything about these worms? Turn us into... Of course it'll turn me into a monster. What else did I expect? Although, it hasn't happened yet. If we can find an expert, someone that can control these things, there might still be time. You know, I was ready to go this alone, but maybe sticking with the herd isn't such a bad idea. And you seem like a useful person to know. All right, I accept.
Lead on.
Meet our new companion, Astarion. By the way, when I was deciding my class, I first thought of choosing Rogue. But now my doubts are gone, because now we already have a Rogue in our party.
Footprints. There may be even more that survived the crash.
Dead goblins over there. Worth checking for supplies, maybe.
Here goes nothing. What's going on with that one?
You approach the sigil on the stone. Magic glitters and swirls from it erratically, as if malfunctioning. It looks slightly dangerous.
Just your average traveler stuck between realms. Pull me out, and we'll get properly introduced.
Gale of Waterdeep. Apologies. I'm usually better at this. A bit shocked, but friend, it's a relief and a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Say, but I know you, don't I? In a manner of speaking. You were on the Nautiloid as well. I can only assume you two were on the receiving end of a rather unwelcome insertion in the ocular region.
No use sugarcoating it, is there? The insertee we speak of, this parasite, are you aware that after a period of excruciating gestation, it will turn us into mind flayers? It's a process known as seramorphosis, and let me assure you, it is to be avoided. You don't happen to be a cleric by any chance, do you? A doctor? Surgeon? Uncannily adroit with a knitting needle?
You seem to know enough about our condition to realize it's beyond most clerics' skills.
Most, no doubt, but I find myself hoping to be in the presence of the few. You don't happen to be one of them. As we've established, few enough can. It's not exactly a common affliction. We're most certainly going to need a healer. And soon, too. How about we lend each other a helping hand once more and look for a healer together? Most excellent! A parasite shared is a parasite halved. Or something to that effect. Oh, but before you think you're about to embark on a journey with most ill-mannered a man, thank you for pulling me out of that stone. It's an act of foresighted kindness, I assure you. For I have the feeling ample opportunities will present themselves for me to return the favor.
There. A mind flayer. And it's hurt.
That thing's bound to be dangerous, even if injured. Best be careful.
You approach the dying monster. This is the thing that abducted you. You could end its life here and now, if only you didn't feel compassion. Compassion! Poor creature is on the brink of death, but there's still time. You'd give your life to save it, to nurse it back to health. But then the feeling slips. The creature's mind seems to focus elsewhere. Your minds fuse, lusting for something that is gone. But then its grip claws back with a vengeance, a vice locking your mind into obedience. It needs sustenance to survive, and with your very body, you can provide. The monster lies exhausted, defeated, Its eyes, wet orange pearls, radiate malice.
Monster. Death is too good for it.
Charmed, I'm sure.
Still alive, so that's progress. Best be on my way.
I've heard you can't get blood from a stone, but apparently you can get a wizard from one. Gale seems interesting. Something the matter?
If you're sure. As you like. Perhaps I'll see you at camp.
Broken. Must have been here a while.
I had to send her to camp because we're about to get yet another addition to our party, which is lost for today. If you don't know, we are allowed only 4 characters in party at once.
You think it's dangerous?
Of course it's dangerous. Zoru was right. Yellow as a toad and twice as ugly.
The thing's dangerous. Leave it for the goblins to kill.
And if it escapes, how will you... Oh, a guest.
Your skull pounds in response to the prisoner's white-hot stare. Her lips don't move, yet you hear her voice.
Get rid of them.
Your words flow to her, though you never speak them aloud.
I know what grows inside you, and I know of a cure.
Demaze, let's...
No. I'm not leaving this fiend with a stranger.
Kill them.
He's right. No one's safe if that thing goes loose. Not even us.
Demaze!
Enough. Lower the trap. Ready your blade.
You've but one chance. Join me or die.
No!
You lying rat!
The witching hour. Survival is all that matters.
The tadpole hasn't yet scrambled all your senses. Auspicious. But the longer we wait, the more it consumes. My people possess the cure for this infection. I must find a creche. You will join me. It is many things. A hatchery, a training grounds, a shelter.
Githyanki protocol is clear. When infected with a Geth tadpole, we must report to Augusto for purification.
You may as well suggest a wyvern bow to worms. The cure I offer will suffice as thanks. You do not have the authority. Defer to your leader. They must have carried something useful.
Hello, chum.
The tadpole has... But the... My people possess the cure for this infection. I must find a creche. You will join me. You have made an ally from creche. Come. The Horned Ones mentioned a camp. One there, this Zoru, has seen Githyanki. A creche must be near. We will ask this Zoru where he has seen my kin.
Never a dull moment. For me. If not over, then through. Very well.
You! Not another step, hear me? Boss! Got company up here!
What's this then? Trying to creep around us and loot the crypt? Not happening. Or is it the ship you're after? Don't matter either way. It's ours. All of it. Well, in that case...
Come on, you lot. No point in getting killed. Second worm gets the cheese and all.
Second mouse gets the cheese, no?
Nobody's getting any damn cheese. Now move it!
It would have been quicker to kill them.
Time and the elements have left the plaque unreadable.
I dig inside. Unfortunately, I don't have a shovel yet.
I hear shouting up ahead.
We should check it out, but be careful.
Open the bloody gate!
Nobody gets in! Zevlor's orders!
That pack of goblins will be on us any second!
What's going on?
Goblins are on our tail! Open the gates, Zevlor, now!
You let goblins here? Where is the druid?
Please! There's no time!
By the nine hells! Open the gates! Roach. Provoke the blade.
And suffer its sting.
Our final battle for the day.
On the move.
my sickle and sword.
On the move.
You bow, or you break. Ah!
May it please, Mistra.
Ah!
time to waste.
That was the last of them. Inside, all of you, more may follow. Open the gate!
Good. Down
there. But what were the crummy little beasts after?
This place doesn't look like much.
A taste of goblins to come, I fear. There must be a horde nearby.
Anything of use? How much farther can I go?
So I've collected all the loot and now I will go to our camp, where I will speak with some of the companions and then rest. And this is where I end my voice commentary. If you have any suggestions about my playthrough, please leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching and have a great day.
Something good here, I hope. I'll take that. Seems like a good moment to talk.
A monster forms inside us, and you think to be idle. I knew your kind to be fragile, but I didn't foresee the severity. Be quick about your rest. We must locate a crash. You would doubt me. I do not trust a common healer to extract a Geth tadpole without killing its host. At a crash, a gust still may cleanse us safely. Take your rest. I will stand watch. Should a single tentacle split your skull, I will not hesitate to end you.
Your Geth friend seems on edge. Mustn't relish the thought of sprouting tentacles. Understandable. Can't say I'm a fan either. It's just hard to join in when all of this feels so new. The night normally means bustling streets, bursting taverns. Curling up in the dirt and resting is, a little novel. No. Tea isn't really my drink. I'll be awake a while anyway. I need some time to think things through, to process this. You sleep. I'll keep watch. The pleasure is all mine. Sweet dreams.
Doing the rounds, are you? You'd better get some rest. What were you two talking about? I see. I'd be careful with Lazel. She's not of this world. I'd be surprised if our interests remained aligned. Let's hope we rapidly find a healer.
You seem reliable. I think you know how important it is that we find someone who can cure us. Best if we focus on that.
Good. We might even get lucky and find one right away. As I see it, we're overdue some good fortune. Rest well.